Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Doris.
Doris who?
Doris locked. That's why I'm knocking.
Is it going?
Tell us.
Oh, okay. Okay.
3, 2, 1.
Hi, this is SB.
Okay. Do we keep going? 2, 1.
Hi, this is SB, and you're watching The Roar.
First off, we want to start out by saying congratulations to Mr. Flakey for getting Teacher of the Month.
Yeah, I put 3 fried beans on my taco burger.
Ooh. Ooh. Look at her. She's a bad man with them. Just as fine as she can be.
How is Teacher of the Month chosen, you might be wondering? Well, Teacher of the Month is decided by students attending the CCR meetings with Mr. McKim and Pride Rock.
Flakey isn't the only person who took a dub recently. On Sunday, the Chiefs won the Super Bowl for the first time in 50 years. The team celebrated with friends, family, and 1.5 million fans in the streets of Kansas City yesterday in a parade.
If you're anything like us and don't really understand much about football, but still watch the Super Bowl for the good food and commercials, our last Instagram poll was just for you. We asked students what their favorite Super Bowl commercial was, so we decided to play the one most liked by students.
The Peanut, he spent his life bringing people together. I know he'd be happy that we are all together now.
Yeah.
What is happening?
What is that? Is that a baby nut?
Just kidding. I'm back.
Where's my mom?
The poll actually came to a tie between Baby Nut, which we just watched, and the Google Loretta commercial.
The Google Home commercial was so sweet, but we decided to spare y'all the tears and went with Baby Nut instead.
Yeah, but I feel like the Baby Nut commercial didn't really make sense, like between the Kool-Aid Man and Mr. Clean and the dolphin noises.
That's true, but you know, we aren't really the ones paying millions of dollars to have it air, so to each their own, I guess.
Yep. Make sure to check out our Instagram for more polls so next time you can get the chance to decide what could be on next. Also, make sure to stop by today to see Joey Barber's new video about swim going to UKC.
So Winter Royalty was last weekend as well. Congratulations to Melody Brooks and Joshua Twitchell for winning King and Queen. Everyone looked great, and we hope you had a safe and fun evening.
Lansing and Leavenworth are facing off in a wrestling duo tonight at home. Our basketball team will also play against Leavenworth soon on February 18th.
Now's the time to stock up on your Lansing versus Leavenworth merch from our very own Lions Pad. They're selling t-shirts for $5 and bracelets for only $1.
Make sure to stop by if you're interested in either. To gain access to the Lions Pad, get any LHS gear any day before school.
Speaking of special deals here at school, the Lions Cafe has a great new drink special starting next week on Monday called A Cup of Love. The cafe team asked students to try their new product.
This sure is the only love we'll be receiving this Valentine's Day.
L is for the way you look at me.
How would you rate this drink 1 to 10?
It's about an 8.75. It's good.
How do you feel about this drink?
Oh, I wish my wife was here to share it with me. It's delicious.
It's good. Tastes like love.
Yum.
Yeah. Sounds like the perfect drink for two.
Or one.
So what exactly is in a cup of love?
A cup of love is a Valentine's Day inspired milkshake with strawberries and a Hershey chocolate bar topped with whipped cream and chocolate syrup. The cafe is open before school and during lunch, so make sure to stop by and get yourself a cup of love for $3.
It'll be available to buy next Monday through Wednesday, so make sure to get it one while you can. There are also a few more ways you can treat your Valentine right here. The vending machine in the lunchroom has mini chocolate boxes, and DECA is also selling Valentine's cards during lunch, so make sure to check those both out.
Make sure to come out today, tomorrow, or Saturday to watch the student-led one-act plays at 7 p.m. Admission is $5.
Lastly, we have a little announcement about the literary magazine. Recently, they have been working hard to make a lot of changes to give students an even broader outlet to share their art, music, writing, and more. They have recently introduced a podcast as well, where they invite students to talk about their pieces. Let's hear more about it from the creative writing team behind it.
Students can submit art pieces, photography, poems, short stories, music. We're taking music this year, too.
We started a new podcast. It's supposed to come out every 2 weeks, but sometimes it might come off more often. Basically, we take pieces that either we wrote, the other creative writing class wrote, or submissions. We'll have either the people who wrote them read them to us if they want to, or we'll read them, and then we'll have like a little bit of commentary on what inspired the author to write that piece. And then we'll also just add in fun things like memes and tips and other fun things like that. Sometimes we'll have music if we get any music in there.
Students should submit their work because it's a good way to get noticed. If you want like your pieces to be seen and everything.
Students should submit simply because it's a really good outlet.
Students should submit their work because I think it's a good way that they can express themselves and show their personalities off to other people.
Students can submit their work by going on the Literary Magazine website and going to the submissions button, and they also can email us.
For the most part, it's just like a place for us to have fun and hopefully get like a community that can also just help us have more fun. I just wanna be cool.
You can't tell me that I'm cool. This is a really great way for students to share their work and get noticed among a super positive community. So make sure you check out their website or visit their Instagram at lhs.creative.inc.
And don't forget to check out our Instagram at Lansing Broadcast. That's all we have for you today.
Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next week.